Friended family, please gather around behind the chairs.
Back up where Dave is.
Legion Riders, okay?
Yes.
Thank you, sir. Ma'am, with your permission.
Sir?
Came the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. We gather here to commend our brother, Billy, to God our Father, and to commit his body to the earth. In the spirit of faith and the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, let us raise our voices, offer our prayers for Billy. We read sacred scripture. Come, you who are blessed by my Father, says the Lord. Inherit the kingdom prepared for you in the foundation of the world. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our brother may sleep here in peace until he awakens. Then he will see your face, face to face, and in your light will see light, and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. In our farewell, express our affection for him. May ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day, we shall joyfully greet him when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. About 30 years ago, my faith was lukewarm, and I believed, but I had some doubts. One of my best friends died. I was a teacher in Brigantine for 40 years. One of my best friends died, and my sister died, and I was devastated. And I went into church, and I knelt. Lazarus died. But what did he do? He resurrected to life. So we are promised that he will be resurrected. Billy will be. I can assure you, this is not easy. Catholic cadet day changed my life. And I went from a lukewarm Catholic to a deacon. He goes to Mass every day. And he prays constantly. And he believes in the Holy Trinity. And he prays in the resurrection. Without any doubts. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Billy. And now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness and parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see him again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will dispense and disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another. Let us love one another. Let us pray in the faith of Jesus Christ. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And we ask Our Lady to forgive him, to bring him into the light to her Son. And we pray, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. I can assure you his name will be in my prayers every day until the day that I die. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him. Angels of the Lord, receive his soul and present him God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we commend our brother in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ. And are with you, with our brother, forever. We ask this in Christ our Lord. Amen. Please bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their mind and in their need, and strengthen your hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. May his soul and the souls of the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. And may the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the love of God and the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ bless and console us and gently wipe away every tear from our eyes. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ.
talking to her.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am Sergeant-at-Arms Chuck Knutson, Last Loop, Military Funeral Honor Guard. We're here today to conduct a military funeral honor ceremony. I want to let everyone know what we'll be doing so no one is shocked by any loud noises. In his honor, we'll be firing a Civil War cannon. It is real, and it is loud. There's a couple extra ounces in it. After the cannon fires a single volley, our memorial bell will be rung three times. After the memorial bell is rung three times, our rifle team will fire three volleys. Those are World War II, M1 Garand, 30 caliber weapons. They are also very loud. After the rifles fire, three volleys, taps will be played. The flag will be folded and presented to you, ma'am. Before we begin any of that, I want to draw everyone's attention to our most sacred possession. This is Last Salute's prayer box. Built of wood that was taken within a church that was taken down many years ago. And within it were photographs, prayer cards, today I will read the prayer from the top and ask you to place your loved one inside. And once you do that, he becomes a permanent member of our honor guard. He will travel with us everywhere we go and overwatch everything that we do. Our prayer box has been held and prayed over by countless dignitaries and clergy. Congressmen, senators, mayors, police chiefs, fire chiefs, the Attorney General of the United States, but most notably, many Medal of Honor recipients, one which now resides inside the prayer box. Herschel Williams, the last World War II Medal of Honor recipient, was placed inside by his family just a few weeks ago. Our prayer box was with us at Arlington when we conducted a ceremony at the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. It was flown by Black Hawk helicopter from Fort Dix to Vineland for the changing of the name of the middle school for the first Army Ranger to die in the Black Hawk down battle. It was honored at the battleship New Jersey. It was placed in a military backpack and carried across Parris Island. It was on the rifle range, the gas chamber, the obstacle course, and the crucible. And just this past Memorial Day, it was placed in another military backpack and foot marched 21 miles. All of this is to honor those that we place inside. We will always remember and always honor. Corporal. May the gates of heaven open wide, and the protecting saint of warriors, the Archangel Michael, take hold of our fallen brethren, and raise this guardian soul to paradise. May he wash away the sin and shield against evil, for this fallen defender of a nation and its people has known sacrifice in service of others. Raise your sword and ascend to the safety and peace above us. Relieve this soul of burden and be blessed upon it. Favor this soul whilst we present honor and shroud this noble warrior from darkness and hasten to everlasting light. Ever be righteously vigilant as we render our last salute.
Thank you. present arms.
On behalf of the President of the United States, the entire United States military, and a very grateful nation, please accept this flag as a symbol of our appreciation for your loved one's honorable and dedicated service. It is our honor.
Order. Arm.
Inside this black velvet bag are three brass shells from the rifles which just fired his honor. To it, I am adding the fuse. These items stay on the top side of the flag pin to hold these purposes. Additional shells may be handed out individually or kept as you wish. Ma'am? This is simply a copy of the prayer. Ma'am, we are now going to post a flag at the grave.